In this video, I'll give you a quick but hopefully comprehensive introduction in how to use Yahoo Finance for your stock analysis. Hello, couch investors. My name is Till, and this is the channel that shows you how to invest intelligently and easily, and how you build up a fortune also as an ordinary person with a normal job. Yahoo Finance is a pretty good platform that offers a lot of data for private and professional investors for free. In this video, I show you how to use it and where to find the data that you need for your stock analysis. If you want to know how to do a complete stock analysis, there are a lot of videos on my channel that will show you exactly this. And for this case, I recommend to start with this one here right in the corner, where I'm doing a full analysis of a company. You start with a website, finance.yahoo.com, and log into your account. If you don't have an account yet, you can set up one for free by clicking on Create an Account. To find your specific company, just type the company name or the short code of the stock in the search field. Let's do this for Tesla. Its short code is TSLA. Yahoo automatically provides some suggestions. The one on the top is the stock of Tesla at the Nasdaq stock exchange. There are more entries from other stock exchanges. If you're looking at non-US companies, I recommend to choose the stock exchange of a company's home country, because the company data that we're searching for are sometimes not available for every stock exchange. This is the summary tab. On the left, it shows some information on stock prices, stock price history, or trading volumes. Personally, I never look at those data because, as a value investor, I simply don't need them. In the column right next to it, you'll find some actually useful key data. On top is the market capitalization. This is the most important figure on this tab. It tells you how much the whole company currently costs. So, current stock price times all outstanding stocks. Below the market capitalization, you'll see the PE ratio. PE means price per earnings and gives you an indication on how expensive the company is in relation to what they generate in earnings. This is one of the key figures that Wall Street looks at, and you'll find it just anywhere. Unfortunately, it is not that reliable, why value investors look more on free cash flow. But it is helpful for a quick indication, especially if you're searching for stocks and want to narrow them down to a few. On the right, you see a small stock chart that provides you with a quick overview for time frames between 1 day and 5 years. If you want to look at a bigger version of the chart with different time frames and other options, just click either on Max, Full Screen, or Chart in the menu above. I'm going to create another video on how to use the chart tool that I will link here somewhere above me as soon as it is available. The tab Statistics contains a lot of ratios and valuation figures. If you are interested, most of them are just a waste of time, at least for value investors. As an example for the waste of time category, is forward PE a figure that contains assumptions about the future development of the earnings in relation to the price? But who made these assumptions? Analysts? The company itself? Batman? And based on what? This is completely unclear. Therefore, you better ignore it. By the way, information about what analysts estimate on earnings and revenue, you'll find on the tab Analysis. The price to book and price to sales ratios at least give you an indication on how expensive a company is. For me, the most important information on this page is the number of shares outstanding, which I need for the calculation of the company's value per stock. On the profile page, you receive some basic information about a company. Like, for example, the headquarter, contact address, what they are actually doing, and who the top management is. In this case, you see that the techno king of Tesla is Mr. Elon Musk, and the master of coin is Mr. Zachary Kirkhorn. Yes, those are really the official titles at Tesla for the CEO and the CFO. I'm far from being a Tesla fanboy, but I really like a good portion of humor in a world of seriousness. On the right side, you get some information about upcoming and recent events on the company. Before we come to the most important tab, I'd like to ask you to click the like button if you found this helpful. This is actually supporting my channel a bit. Thank you. For me, the most important tab are the financials. Here you find the data from the income statement, the balance sheet, and the statement of cash flows. In the top right corner, you can choose if you want to have the view on an annual basis or a quarterly basis. The overview provides you with the data for the past 4 years, plus the trailing 12 months or the past 5 quarters. If you want to view them in a more condensed perspective, you can click on Collapse All, or if you want to view the details, click on Expand All. For value investors, especially the tabs Balance Sheet and Cash Flows are interesting. The balance sheet contains the assets, split into current and non-current assets and its various details. And the liabilities, also split into current and non-current liabilities. You will need these figures for calculating some of the most important valuation figures. The liquidation value, also called the shareholders' equity, is one of the two parts of the company's overall value, and it tells you how much the owners get if the company would be liquidated today. The invested capital tells you, as the name says, how much capital is actually invested in the company. And the CROIC, which tells you something about how strong the company is with generating cash on the invested capital, which is indirectly a good indicator of the speed of growth. The tab Cash Flow contains the information of the company's statement of cash flows. This is split into 3 sections: the operating cash flow, the investing cash flow, and the financing cash flow. For me, the most important information is the free cash flow. You can calculate this by taking the operating cash flow and deduct the capex of it. The capex you'll find as an entry in the section Investing Cash Flow. Free cash flow tells you something about the ability of the company's operating business to generate cash. Why this is so important, I'll show you in the 2 videos on free cash flow that I'm going to set a link to somewhere here in the corner. It doesn't consider all of the other financial stunts that a company can do. If you want to know more about this, have a look at the section of the investing and the financing cash flow. Value investing seems to become more popular today, so Yahoo Finance already calculates the free cash flow for you. You'll find the figure on the bottom of the table. I like this as a quick indication, but sometimes it didn't fit to the manually calculated figures. So be a bit careful with this and really just use it for a quick indication. And if you want to know how you easily create watch lists for your stocks with Yahoo Finance, you should watch this video here. See you next time.